Does the movie Ferrari have the horsepower to be a blockbuster? What about how Elvis Presley met Priscilla? And ahead of Australia Day later in the week, what are your favourite Aussie flicks? For me, it's always The Castle, but it is time for entertainment. And at the desk is movie analyst himself, Shane A. Bassett. Good morning.
Good morning. I love that introduction.
Yeah, we'll talk about The Castle, Dale Dug a Hole a little later on, and a few other Aussie flicks, because there's been so many great ones. But let's begin. Everyone is fascinated by the lives of people like Michael Jackson, the Beatles, Elvis Presley.
Yes. Well, this new Elvis movie, which is called Priscilla, isn't really an Elvis movie. It's a daring portrayal of Priscilla as a teenager when she met Elvis Presley and the murky surroundings that went on behind the scenes, because she was only very young. She was a teenager. But he kept in contact with her and almost held her until she was old enough so he could marry her. But it's nothing like the Baz Luhrmann Elvis that we saw last year.
Put it that way.
It's very good when it comes to the acting, but it's emotionally draining at times. Kaylee Spaney, who is Priscilla, she's only young, but she's such a convincing actress. And I think the female point of view from the director, Sofia Coppola, who's the daughter of famous Francis Ford Coppola, her values of what to look at in the film around the actors themselves make it an outstanding film. And Jacob Elordi plays Elvis, Australian actor. So there's a lot to like, but it's a little bit emotionally draining throughout.
Is that out now?
It is out now in cinemas,
okay,
yes.
OK, Priscilla. Now, what about Ferrari? Two of my children went yesterday. One really liked it. Yep. One was a little bit in between. What did you think?
I'm just, like, in between as well, because what they were hoping to be a big blockbuster that was going to get all these award nominations, it simply hasn't happened. Not because of not trying. It looks good. It's a sleek movie. You've got Adam Driver, who's amazing as Enzo Ferrari. Mm. And it's only a passage of time within the 1957-58 time period that we look at, that his company was going into downfall. So we get some good car scenes, but it's not all about the car racing. It's about his suffering in the business that he's built up, and all of a sudden it's gone flat for him. Penelope Cruz is terrific as his assistant, who does a little bit more than assist him in certain ways.
Okay.
Yeah, but I liked it, but it is quite a slow movie and deflating. The tyres were a bit deflated, Tim.
Okay. So not quite the horsepower.
Not quite.
We're using them all this morning.
Yeah, why not? I liked it, but it's not one that I'd rush out and go and see.
I do like true stories, and that's a true story, as is the next movie we're going to talk about. A harrowing true story of a plane crash in the snowy mountains in the Andes.
Yeah, this movie, this story has been done before. True story, it was done in the 90s and in a movie called Alive. And this new version is a lot more graphic, a lot more harrowing. If you have a fear of flying, don't watch it, because there's a plane crash depicted at the start that is just so realistic. You're going to look at it and go, whoa. It is about a rugby team that falls in the Andes. They crash land. It's very snowy in mountains. It's the 70s, so there's no mobile phones or communication. And they resort to some very extreme survival tactics to stay alive. I don't want to go into too much detail.
A bit of the Lord of the Flies about it.
There is a little bit of that. There is a little bit of that. But it's the surroundings and the cinematography of this movie. It's just
What's
amazing.
What's it called?
Society of the Snow.
And is it good?
It's very good. Mm. Yeah. Just be prepared, though, because it's not one you're going to be recommending to your friends, probably.
Okay, it's a grueling, but
it's a grueling film. But I enjoy the acting, I enjoy the cinematography, and how they survived is something that you, as a human, would have to really make a big decision whether you wanted to do that or not.
All right, change of pace. Why would you want to go out to some fancy restaurant where this keeps coming up night after night? That is one of Daryl Kerrigan's great lines in a great Australian movie. It is Australia Day on Friday.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, and we've got some great Australian films to think about.
Well, some of my favourites, I mean, I could list many. I'm a real advocate for Australian film. Mm. I love our local projects and actors and cinematography and everything that comes with an Australian project. We make some good ones. But Two Hands is one of my favourites from 1999. Muriel's Wedding, which is having a 30th anniversary this year, 1994.
The picture's there.
Amazing.
Hard to believe.
Yeah. Really good. I love Muriel's Wedding. That put Toni Collette back on the map. on the map, actually. That's where she took off. She'd done some previous movies before that, but this really took off overseas. Mad Max, the original Mad Max from 1979. I love all the Mad Maxes, but that original just never gets old. And they did it on a shoestring budget. I really love Mel Gibson in this. He went into the audition with bruises on his face. He'd been in the blue the night before or something. Yeah, terrific. Yeah. Terrific scenery.
Absolutely. And so many wonderful Australian movies. I was talking to someone yesterday about Breaker Morant, which was
Brian Brown, one of our absolute legends. Edward Woodward was in that, of course. Yeah, Breaker Morant.
Jack Thompson.
Who's still acting. Mm. He still pops up. So does Brian Brown. He's in a popular television show at the moment called Boy Swallows World.
Yeah.
But Heath Ledger, this was just an incredible performance from him in two hands. Brian Brown, we just spoke about him. Rose Byrne, you know, these young actors came through in this movie, filmed around Sydney, and Rabbit Proof Fence. Now, they're talking about harrowing. This was a harrowing story, true story. A couple of young girls making their way back home, following the Rabbit Proof Fence in outback Australia. Philip Noyce directed this. And Kenneth Branagh was in it, Deborah Mailman, amazing film.
Yeah, absolutely.
Watched it again recently and it really does not lack any punch.
It's absolutely
a terrific Australian production.
Yeah, brilliant film. Well, we've got plenty to watch on Australia Day if we're going to sit there in front
of choice.
In front of the telly. We'll do it again next week.
Thanks, Tim. Have a great day.
Bassett. Yeah, great to see you.